Many thanks to John Massier, Ed Cardoni, and Paul Little for keeping this organization running for such a long time. My name is Peter Boes, and I'll tell you about this piece here. I'll tell you about it physically and what it means to me metaphysically. So the base itself is obviously a piece of marble with a wooden ringer on it, which I got from my grandmother. And the seashells are stuff that I've gathered through the course of time. This wire itself is from a my garage door got fixed. These leaves are stuff that I've collected from the backyard. I have a Japanese maple tree by my back deck. And I don't know what species of leaves these are, but they're from a bush that I have on my back deck. And this rim here that Ed asked me about at the opening represents a relationship. And obviously, we're in a bad relationship, and we're going to be talking about it. Anyways. So basically, this is supposed to transcend time, because over the course of time, even at moment, through every moment in time, you know, the constant birth, death, and decay to observe momentary time itself. So this piece is not necessarily intended for a museum, because you'd have to refresh it. You'd have to, if you had a day to yourself to go for a little walk, and you'd have to, you know, pick a leaf from nature and put it on the foundation. So this is another thing that also dawned on me during the creation of this piece, is that I can work in both directions. I can, you know, start with an idea and go to start from the bottom, and start from the foundation and work my way up. And this is the first piece that price on request popped in my mind. I know another artist that had done the same thing, something that he made, and that was pretty profound. So basically, this, as artistically, this piece represents me developing a closer relationship with God, like the first artist who shared, so artists from church, which I can definitely relate to. It's very personal in nature, and it's constantly evolving. Right? So, and then I like also like what Jack was saying, like you can orient the pieces of the list, you know. So if you want to, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be where it is, you can place it however you're feeling, you know, how you want to do it, you know. That's really static, you know. So I like the fact that you can reorient stuff, you know, in time and space. Questions from the audience?
Can you add anything to it?
If you like.
Yeah. I mean, like something.
Sure. So obviously these leaves are in a state of decomposition. You can always, like I said, so this would be intended for, you know, someone's personal ownership, not necessarily a museum. Like, say, if you're walking one day and just went to a deep thought, you know, add a new fresh leaf from Mother Nature. Oh, and then, okay, so another thing I want to tell the audience is that one of our patrons that was visiting the gallery said it represented a deep longing, right? So it was my longing to basically just become happy with myself, you know, as an artist and comfortable in my own skin. Any other questions?
Okay, thanks, Peter.